Persistence. I can touch my toes for the first time since high school. It's insane. It's a little sad, frankly, that it's taken me this long to take my stretching seriously. Oh man, and this is all going to connect to plantar fasciitis, running injuries, all of that. But what you're seeing on your screen right now is basically how far I could stretch 6 months ago. And one of my goals was to be able to touch my toes by January 1st, 2019. Well, that was a little bit of an unrealistic goal, and I made that goal because I was battling plantar fasciitis September, October, November of 2018, so 6, 7, 8 months ago. And I thought I was doing research, trying to figure out why do I continue to struggle with PF in my life. And based on all the research that I've done, and I'll just mention now at the beginning, I'm not a doctor, I just have running experience and 4 bouts of PF in my life, all right? So I have a lot of experience, unfortunately, but if you listen to your doctor, don't listen to me, listen to your podiatrist, but I am not afraid to simply share what has worked for me in the past and what I plan to do moving forward to push back against PF. And just so you know, I know we've talked about this topic quite a bit, and the reason I'm bringing it up again, plantar fasciitis, is because a lot of you email me, send me messages on Instagram, Strava, asking for help with your plantar fasciitis. So that's why I'm revisiting it. And the second reason I'm bringing it up today is because I am sooner rather than later about to transition out of the boot. And so let's dive in right at the beginning with the question of the day. Who has struggled with plantar fasciitis in the past, or who is struggling right now? I know that's very niche, and a lot of you might feel excluded from this question of the day. If you feel excluded, that's a good thing. You don't want to have this injury. And in fact, I will propose another question. What is worse, plantar fasciitis or stress fractures? Since I have had many of both in my life, I can tell you, hands down, plantar fasciitis is worse. It just lingers. It's a soft tissue, soft tendon injury. Bone injuries like a stress fracture can heal in, 4 weeks, 6 weeks, 8 weeks. Whereas PF, if you get it bad, sometimes it just feels like it heals and returns to normalcy at a sloth-like pace. So just putting that out there, it's a really tough injury. Sometimes you can run through it, but sometimes you cannot, and that is when it gets really challenging. So again, the reason I'm bringing this topic up now is because as I transition out of this boot, which I'm so ready to be done with the boot, my foot has been walking funky in the boot for the last 2 to 3 weeks, meaning the muscles, the tendons, the ligaments, everything basically below my, well, really my entire leg, but especially everything below my knee, all my muscles are, seizing up a little bit, just a little bit. Now I'm working out in the pool, trying to keep my legs moving as best as possible, but everything is out of its normal routine because I'm in this boot. And now in retrospect, looking back at my entire history with plantar fasciitis, I wish I would have known the following. First of all, the pain, for me, happens in the heel, usually on the, like sometimes people can feel it more so toward the arch of their foot, but for me, it was definitely on the heel, and that's where it's that tendon connects to your heel, and oh, it's so painful. It's on the inside. A lot of times, you probably, if you've had this before, you know that it hurts the worst in the morning, because over the time you're sleeping, that tendon gets tighter and tighter and tighter because of how your foot is not moving all night long. And so then you step out of bed, and the pain is just, it can be shooting like a knife poking into your heel, no joke. I wish I would have known that you actually do not want to be massaging the heel area. I made that mistake just last year. I thought that breaking up or at least trying to alleviate some of the pain in the heel was the way to go. So I would massage with all these different tools that I have. Actually, this foot log is one of them, and I love this thing. But I learned over time through research, through talking to other runners, talking to a podiatrist, you don't want to massage the heel. Rather, you can massage the arch, right? You can massage the arch, just stay away from the heel area. And point number two for what I wish I would have known about PF and getting rid of it, it's not a foot injury. And this is so crazy, and I'm exaggerating. I'm making a point here. It's little micro tears, okay? It's little micro tears in that tendon that connects to your heel, and really severe cases, that tendon can actually start to separate a little bit from your heel bone. Instead, it's caused, plantar fasciitis is caused from your entire, and yes, chain is the key word, your entire kinetic chain from your lower back to your glutes, to your hamstrings, to your soleus and gastroc muscle in your calf, to your Achilles tendon, to your fascia tendon, all the way down to your toes. It's that entire kinetic chain is tight, meaning you probably aren't stretching. That was me in 2018. I wasn't stretching enough. Now, and this is crazy, but glass half full attitude all the time, right? Because of my stress reaction in my left foot right now, and that's why I'm in the boot, I've been able to get to the gym basically every day. And I've hopped on the machine that you saw me on earlier, this machine right now, almost every day. Not every day I go to the gym, but I would say 90% of the time I'm on there for 10 minutes, stretching my hamstring, stretching my glutes, stretching a little bit on the lower back, striving to loosen up my entire kinetic chain. And now, after 4 to 5 weeks of consistent stretching on that machine, and if you're looking for a gym to join, ask them if they have this machine, and ask them if they don't, if they could get one. If you're a long distance runner, I'm telling you, this thing might save me from ever getting plantar fasciitis ever again. That's at least my aspiration and goal, because now, just a little test today, I can now touch my toes. I realize I'm not touching as well as I'd like to, but I can at least approach touching my toes, which means my entire kinetic chain is loosening up, and I am, oh, it is so painful to stretch. I would rather go run 40 miles all out rather than stretch my hamstrings. It just hurts so bad for me. I don't know why, but it's getting easier. And one last point before a quick recap. I ran through my last bout of plantar fasciitis fall 2018. I continued to train, continued to run. It was very painful, but it warmed up over time. I wish I would have been way more aggressive with stretching, meaning 10 to 20 minutes at least every single day, preferably even twice a day if you have the time, where you're just stretching and stretching your entire kinetic chain. But what helped, one of the shoes, yes, that helped me continue running was the New Balance Beacon. This shoe relieved a little bit of the pain. It didn't eliminate it, but it helped me get through it. I don't know what it was. This is a 6mm drop, something with how this midsole is formed. This shoe, out of all the shoes that I own, helped me the most with getting rid, no, sorry, not get rid, helped me run through my plantar fasciitis pain. Okay, and just a quick recap, once again, don't massage your heel. That's my recommendation, because that fascia tendon, where it connects to the heel, it's inflamed and it's upset and it needs to simmer down, okay? Rather, massage your arch gently at first, but then slowly working into that arch, just trying to loosen everything up, but just stay away from the heel. And then, yes, stretching your entire kinetic chain, top to bottom, lower back, all the way down to your toes, but most especially, all those big muscles above your feet, okay? That is the tension of everything above your feet is what's actually causing your PF to bark at you and to give you pain, all right? Again, chain is key word for that kinetic chain, and the question of the day I already asked. So, and actually, I'll just, a little addendum to the QD. How did you get over your PF? Let us know. Maybe you have another part of the story that we don't know about with respect to alleviating this horrible, horrible pain. And I'm with you. I'm telling you, it's so sad. It's sad. There's no other way to say it. It's a sad injury because it hurts so much, and you can still usually run through it, but it just hurts so much. So I'm here for you. I'm here to help as best I can. Seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. See you tomorrow. Oh, man. Good day. Good day. Woo! I can touch my toes!